still the Nzande. So my point is, if athletes are running on the grass, athletes are running in gravels, you expect them to make the same time for those in the States.
It's not possible.
It is not possible.
It is not possible.
Now you have talented athletes here. I can make mention of some local athletes. Matabisa is number one on the list. You see, we don't have
But she should be competing in the main Olympics by now.
Out of the five events, she's competed in only two.
Only two?
Yes, all on grass.
Because all of the competitions we have done, or we have not opened up the competitions to all
the... Yes. Yeah. Yes, all that she's competed in was on grass.
That's Matabisa, yeah.
It's on grass. Mm-hmm. So my point is...
But Martha doesn't run on grass.
Yes, my
she
point is...
She didn't win her Olympic medal on grass.
We do not have a long-term plan for the association.
Okay.
Martha made it in, how do you call it?
Nanjing.
Yes, by winning gold medal. The only gold medalist in Olympics, whether you like it or not.
Yeah, yeah.
But my point is, if you have somebody like Matabisa, mm-hmm. and she's still in Ghana, nothing is being done to help the girl go to U.S., how do you expect a medal from her in 4 years?
But must she necessarily go to the U.S.?
Because
we can even develop the talent here. Because you made a point earlier.
You've developed
the local athletes are not getting good opportunities to be very good.
Yes.
Then there's a problem.
Yes. You've developed the talent already. Now, what is the next stage?
Because it's disappointing that Martha won the gold medal in 2014.
2014.
And she's not, it's possible she won't compete in the next Olympics, the senior Olympics, Mark.
No.
Mark, that's disappointing.
She could.
She could?
Yes.
If she's running on grass.
No, but so you keep hitting this grass thing. I love the fact that you're hitting
it. But you know that
they
won't go and compete. It's like Heart of Oak that trains at the, how do you call it? At the Lotteries Park, which is the Sakura Park, and still expect to win games.
Yes.
This 21st century. So they did it many years ago. It helped, but you see, things have changed. Times have changed.
Yeah.
So you have to train on grass. That's why Kenichi is training on grass, and he's getting the results. Yes.
No, that's not the case. You're making it sound as if all the GA has managed is to run on competitions on grass.
You have mentioned that two run on grass, three on tartan tracks.
Yes.
So which tartan tracks? The one in Kumasi.
Kumasi and Elwak, and it's very pathetic.
Very bad.
Very pathetic. And I'll tell you something about
that. So all of these things are maybe contributing to,
of course,
how we're not getting local athletes to qualify straight to the Olympics.
Yes, but let me just say,
but Mark, could
things.
There be a way?
There is a way.
Maybe taking these athletes on a tour of maybe Togo, if Togo has better tracks than us.
Now we
because
have
clearly sports clearly in Ghana.
Yeah, we have
our priority for sports has never been clear for many years. We can't fix certain tracks that will require maybe less than 100,000 euros to do. So as for our matter is a different matter. So if we're waiting for Nulante's sports ministry to fix it, we're joking. So couldn't there be a plan? If I don't know, or maybe I'm not getting this whole thing, I'm getting too emotional.
Ernest, can I break it down for you? See, countries like
you seem to understand me, yes, so I want to break it down.
Yes, I'm coming. Countries like Nigeria, right? Countries like Nigeria, before you can go into a major competition, mm-hmm. whether you're a foreign-based athlete, you are under the sea, you are a local-based mm-hmm. athlete, you have to come to Nigeria and compete. Out of it, they make their selections. Mm-hmm. This is not the case for Ghana. Mm-hmm. And one other thing is that you look at Usain Bolt, he always go back to Jamaica to run and make sure he qualifies before he'll be selected for Olympics mm-hmm. or any major championship. I'm looking at the gap between the local athlete and the foreign athlete and how best we can help them. Mm-hmm. That is the only point I'm making for
Mark,
now.
There's a sticking point there.
Yes, you make a lot of sense. But I
could
want
there
to
be
just
a plan?
Yes,
could
there's a plan.
Could we have a plan that will take these guys away from this country? Because if we realize that maybe Martha is a talent, this one is a talent, 20 of them at least, we can end up getting 10 locals who qualify for the games. So we take them away from a tartan track that's in Surrey State mm-hmm. and then running on grass to somewhere so that we can improve our chances of qualifying more at least to the games.
Everybody knows that we have 10 competitions scheduled in Ghana.
Okay.
The first two are developmental competitions where we go at least every year. We try to reach.
Do you need developmental competitions?
Of course.
In 2015, weeks or months to
Olympics.
The Olympic Games.
We started in January.
When the focus is qualifying athletes to take part in the Olympics.
We started in January, 6 clear months.
Okay.
Or 7 clear months before Olympics.
Okay.
If we don't take
a that's
star,
a good time. It's not bad. It's
if
not
we
bad
don't
time.
Take a star to Bolga or Koforidua mm-hmm. for the people there who are also budding athletes mm-hmm. to see that, oh, Charlie, this is a star. I need to, this is somebody I can aspire to. Mm-hmm. How do they
get there? Are you taking them? Because I know, Margaret Simpson, I know.
Yeah, right? We took Margaret.
But the fan-based athletes don't necessarily. I've not seen.
And I'll come down to that. Mm-hmm. I'll come down to that. That issue of having national championships in Ghana and so forth. If we don't take those people, how do we discover them? Number one. So let's leave it there. But the plan was go to at least two places with no tartan tracks. Mm-hmm. Take everybody there. Let them also appreciate what goes on
great.
In the grassroots.
So you got talent from there.
Yes,
we got talent. Where are they? Did you subsequently take them to
yes? So then the tartan yes, they come. Place? Yes, so now we're done with the two cinder, mm-hmm. and we're going to start tartan this Saturday.
But you've been doing this for a while. But yes. It is an Olympic year. Do you not think
it's
that
only
the plan?
Two.
No, hold on. It's an Olympic year. Do we not think that the plan could be revised a bit just to get the Olympic focus sorted? That in 2015 we organized competitions or development opportunities, but Olympic Games, let's try and see if we can push to qualify some more athletes locally to take part in the Olympics.
Yes, that's the goal. That's the goal. So beyond
and you're
that,
sure we'll qualify local athletes? Are you sure we'll get some local athletes to,
I am
to go to Rio?
If you know I listed a few things and I think I'll get there to as an athlete, to make it to the top level. It is not just the facility, it is not just, it takes so much. Number one is the athletes themselves, number two their coach, number three the administration, sporting administration, and then number four government. If there are no facilities to get there, you won't make it. If you as an athlete won't decide that, or doesn't have that mindset that I want to be a professional, that I want to be an elite athlete, and start thinking and working towards it, you won't make it.
Okay.
If your coach is not good, you won't make it. If the association doesn't have a good plan for you, you won't make it. So all those things come into play.
So we're sure we'll qualify some local athletes.
Let
me go back with you to Seoul 88. We took a contingent of 18. Mm-hmm. We had 11 mm-hmm. Of them athletes. Mm-hmm. Those were the days of Leo's brother, John. John okay. Miles Mills, the likes of Francis Dodu today, who is the chairman of the GAA. We had then Martha Pia, Veronica Bewa, at least 11 of them.
Yeah.
Then in Barcelona 92, we had 8 athletes. The numbers dropped a bit. The likes of Emmanuel Tufour, mm-hmm. Miles Mills' brother was still there. Mm-hmm. You still had Francis Dodu competing. Mm-hmm. So at least you had some relay. We had a relay team. Mm-hmm. We also had mm-hmm. some jumpers. Mm-hmm. In Francis Dodu triple jumper, and then in Atlanta 1996 we had 15 track and field athletes. So the likes of Eric Nkansa, Emmanuel Tufour, name them. Francis Dodu himself was there. Andrew Wusu was there. We had some ladies: Mercy Adi, Vidancia, Aziz Zakari. Remember him. And then let's go on to Sydney 2000, some of our highest points. Aziz got to the final of the 100 meters, 2000 and 2004 in Sydney and in Athens. We had 17 athletes, our highest number, 17 of them. Mm-hmm. You know, so we had our 4x400 team, our 4x100 team. We had some jumpers, we had some sprinters. Vidancia was there, Monica Chum. Remember, Leo Miles Mills himself was there. Mm-hmm. Then to Athens 2004, we had 9. So Eric Nkansa, Aziz Zakai was there again, Leo was there, Andrew Wusu was there, Vaide Nim. And then in Beijing, we had only 3. Sad. London, only 3. Currently, only 4. So you trace our representation and it hasn't been good.
Yeah.
Aside that, the performances have been horrible.
Yes.
From after Aziz Zakari's
final
uniquely solid performances in the build up to the final and regrettable performances in the final. At least now we're not even getting that. Mm-hmm.
Yes, I keep saying we don't plan as a country. One, we are not getting the backing of the government. Mm-hmm. They are not pumping money into.
I've told you that the vision of government for sports is non-existent.
Okay.
It has been like this for a long time.
Yes.
You see, it won't change. This government, maybe the government before, we've not seen any clear-cut plan, policy for sports mm-hmm. that allows for sports to be independent, mm-hmm. self-generating financially and financially sufficient enough. So that's not an issue to discuss, because we have been going back and forth with the issue of a sports bill that has been discussed widely as the answer to all of the financial problems we have managing sports in this country. Mm-hmm. But we are still not past it since 2008. So mm-hmm. that's a different matter. Let's go on to other things. So leave government out of it. Government won't do fuck.
Yes. Now, the GAA as a body, I think they are not doing much, because they should be able to seek for sponsorship.
But Kweku, it's not easy. You see, the issue about sponsorship.
You see, the brand hasn't sold itself well.
Okay.
I'm not just talking about this.
Is a football brand selling itself very well in Ghana?
I think so, no matter where they get their sponsorships.
No, no, not for the Ghana Premier League. The Ghana Premier League has been running without a sponsor.
Yes.
You know, so it tells you the sorry state in which sports is. And to some of us, it's very passionate, because this is where we live. Mm-hmm. And this is what we do. If sports is not working, a lot of us are out of job. Jobs. We don't have a livelihood. Mm-hmm. You get the point. Mm-hmm. So football is having its struggles as well. I am not holding brief for Ghana Athletics, because mm-hmm. obviously we could do better than we're doing.
Yes.
Because you can't explain how you'd run on these tartan tracks and on grass.
Yes.
And there's no excuse for it that because we need to allow for talents to be spotted. No!
mm-hmm. So our athletes are not motivated much enough. We don't have good facilities. Talk about gyms, talk about the tartan tracks. If you go to Ewak, I'm sure you cry.
I don't like
to
go
there. There are portals in the tartan tracks. Yes, which is not good for any athlete to qualify. It is not the best. I mean, you run on it, you get injuries. And at the end of the day, you use your own money to cater for yourself. Nobody will take care of you.
I had this very unfortunate conversation with an athlete on Saturday when mm-hmm. it was time for the 800. And he looked visibly shaken and paranoid. And I said, why? He said, last time I came here, I was a victim of an injury, because he slipped on the concrete.
On the airwalk?
Wow. Yes. And so he said today he's not going to go all out. And it's disheartening.
So when that happens, you obviously cannot qualify for the Olympics, because you put in your everything. So that's the sticking point again for Ghana Athletics.
And I have
you know all of these challenges.
That's what we have
so
to do.
If you send local athletes onto those tracks, mm-hmm. you know you won't get the best out of them. And realistically, we can qualify them to the Olympics.
And if you look at our calendar, the rest of our competitions are all in either Cape Coast.
What can we do, Mark?
Yes.
What can we do, Mark? Let's make progress. We have 15 minutes to the top of there. What can we do? What must we do? At least now we need to improve the numbers, because if we took 3 athletes the last time and now we have qualified for, that's not good enough.
And really,
and we're supposed to be managing athletics so well, because I hear a lot of plaudits for Professor Dodu's administration. He's been there since 2009, is it? That's what, 7 years.
Yes, now.
And I hear he speaks greatly about how you guys have managed athletics, but you're taking 3 athletes to the Olympic Games.
Well,
I don't know if that is testament of good athletics management.
It's not over yet.
So but you have a track record.
Please,
you did that
please
in,
don't
in
write
2012.
Us off.
After 3 years of managing, you took 3 athletes. And after 7 years of managing, you've qualified for over 100 days to the competition.
The question you have to ask yourself is, while we're in office, are we making progress?
So where's the progress? Where's the progress when Olympic Games is coming up and a little over 100 days to the Olympic Games? We're talking about 4 athletes.
2012.
And you have told me that the projections were a bit higher. Mm-hmm. That is disappointing that at this point we're discussing only 4.
Yes. Well, no. It is because the people we expect to compete haven't competed yet.
And you also don't have the facilities. You don't have the resources.
Locally,
look at the tracks.
The only
and
place we
on
have
grass.
Now we have Cape Coast. Cape Coast.
Is it ready now?
It's ready.
Is the tartan track
just not commissioned?
Good.
Yes.
Very good.
Well, we haven't seen it, but it's yet to be commissioned.
No, but do we need to commission before we? Because we don't
they
have
won't
time.
Allow
what
us
is
to
wait?
Compete there until it's
are commissioned. We politicizing this one too? The people in authority, do they realize that we have the Olympic Games to run, or you guys are not putting enough pressure? You're not making clear your plans.
We are putting pressure, but it has to be a collective effort to make athletics work in Ghana.
Look, I think we are not getting the truth from GAA, mm-hmm. most especially with Francis Dodi, simply because if you look at all the years that we've gone for Olympics, mm-hmm. we've qualified with a certain number.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yes. But with this administration, it hasn't been the same. Now, my point is, you can only judge their performance.
That, prior to 2009, when Professor Dodu became the president of the Ghana Athletics Association, we took only three to Beijing in 2008.
Yes.
Before Beijing, Athens, we had nine.
Yes.
Before Athens in Sydney, we had 17.
Yes.
Before Sydney in Atlanta, we had 15.
Yes.
Okay, so but the numbers at least have been dwindling.
Yes. But what I'm trying to say is that, see, you can only judge their administration by seeing the number of athletes who qualify for World Championship 1.
Very important.
Which we did not. Mm. We are actually supposed to go on a wild card. And we all know what happened. Mm. The people went there and athletes couldn't get there.
Yeah, right.
Yes, it means nobody qualified for World Championship.
You're right.
That was when I saw that there was a disaster for this country in terms of athletics.
No, okay. Now with Olympics. Two people qualified by performance.
Okay.
By performance.
Okay. But athletes never got to there.
Because they denied their visas.
Okay. No.
Yeah, so that's another part. No. But we didn't compete at the games.
But
so
the president got there. Athletes couldn't get there. Okay, yes. It's so funny.
Yes, because so we'll finish
yes.
your point.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And now.
So that's the tartan tracks.
Yes.
You can see.
You know what? It's very pathetic.
So
it's
this on this we expect our athletes to reach Rio
2016. Train and go around with Usain Bolt.
No, you can't do this. And Mark, we're saying
there are no starting blocks for athletes.
No starting blocks.
We have starting blocks. They refuse to use them.
Oh, but how on. Do they refuse? You are managing the sport. How would your athlete do? These athletes appreciate the fact that you're not doing this for entertainment and that you have to get this done properly.
And by the way,
because of the future
kids,
of it, some of
program.
Them are not wearing they are wearing
this
socks.
This yeah. is part of the KISS Athletics program, which tells you we're also developing athletics from the grassroots. You're mentioning that
developing athletics with the kids running. With these yeah. young people, you 15 years running without boots.
The numbers are dwindling.
Mark, I think
when you look at it, if you don't have a pipeline project or a pro for, if you don't have a plan for people to fit into the shoes.
But we
of
have talked about this plan before from 2009. We talked about a revamp. Yeah. We talked about a revision of plan and everything. And that if the result did not show in 2012 in the Olympics, it will show in the World Championship, Africa Championship, and then the Olympics in 2016. When
I've
seen that,
I'll ask you. I'll say something and then I'll ask you one question, or I'll just make the comment. Mm. Since 2012 to date, 15 national records have been broken.
But they have resulted in what?
And very well. That is the point.
No, no, and they have resulted in what? They have won us medals internationally.
Yes. No. You mentioned all these names mm-hmm. that they have done this and this and that. We've taken 16, 17 to this Olympics.
Yeah.
How many medals did they bring?
So another point, which is a sticking point, is that, no, hold it.
Yeah.
When we encourage participation a lot more. Mm-hmm. If you take 17 people to the Olympics, it is not the same. When you take three. So
yes,
the 17 may go and not win anything, but you still took up to 17, which means the opportunity was broader.
Yes.
Which means the net was cast wider.
Yes.
But if you are taking three, which means you even failed to create a bigger opportunity for more people to win medals. That's the point.
So we started a pipeline project in 2012. Mm. It's improving, they are growing, they are maturing. They are all majority of them are university students now. And they are at least doing well per our standards. Because when you consider their performances now versus the people that are on your list that we are saying they did so well, their performances are better than those back in the day because they have broken their records.
Okay.
What we have to know that also is that the world standards are going up.
Okay.
Ghana has to work
hard. I'm often not thrilled by records when they don't use
Once you break a record, that means you must automatically qualify.
But that's the point. If you break a record
and you don't qualify,
but if this guy set records 20 years ago and you are now
breaking it and you are not qualified for any competition,
qualify you to any major
it tells you the world standards are also going higher. Yeah, Ghana also has.
So it means that we're trailing.
Yes, yes.
And we're trailing so poorly we can't explain. Let's get on, guys. So, but let's be realistic. Alex has already qualified 800 meters. Can he deliver a medal to us? Let's begin to do the prediction.
I can't promise for
we
my
can't
athletes.
Promise for
yes.
now.
Yeah,
you know anything about
is
Alex?
Too early.
Too early.
No.
Okay.
No,
how about John? Him. We're not too sure. Sean? Flings?
No, we can't speak for the athletes.
Just a few highlights before we go. Okay, so that's Sean. We're hoping that he will deliver a medal or do at least get to the final, like Aziz Zakari. and disappoint. But we know you got to the final.
Sean is the one who decided to run for Ghana.
To run for Ghana, yes. Okay. Achun Yamadi has broken the national decathlon record. And he's 200 points shy of qualification. He's currently number one in Africa. The guy is supposed to be number one in Africa, but has not reached the Olympic Games. You think about it and you don't understand. I mean, that's the point. Regina and Abigail, they both qualified for the Africa Championship high jump. We're hoping that they will hit the point, even though it doesn't look too easy. Nadia has also broken the national indoor triple jump record, 13.49 meters. So that we don't know. She's also a bit like 10 points or so. That won't be easy to recover. Emmanuel Dasso breaks the 200 and 400 meter indoor records, 20.89, 46.21. But Mark, my point is all of these things, whether you break records set, because if you are breaking records set 20 years ago, it must be a phenomenal thing. It must be a Usain Bolt-like record-breaking performance that is winning you a world title. We're breaking these records, but these guys can't even qualify.
Yeah, so we just need to work harder. I mean, what I was going to propose a few things.
Okay.
When you look at the countries that are doing well,
yeah,
they have structures in place.
Okay.
That means solid planning, facilities.
But you guys have it.
Everything.
The kind you have.
Yeah, we have the. If you have the plans in place, mm-hmm. but you don't have the facilities, they took
the facilities the are not there. But what out, are the alternative
they
took
the plans? The track out of the stadium.
Great. But so yes. So then it means that the very basis for your planning. It's been porous, it's been poor, yes. Because when you plan, you know you don't have the tracks,
yes.
So then it must play a significant role in your planning
so
process.
You have
that
to
because I don't have the tracks, yes. I may have to run somewhere else.
Yes, you have to make do with what you have and try to make sure you can still deliver.
Okay.
Since 2012, he mentioned no national championships. We haven't received a dime from the government to organize anything. 2012, ask me how we're surviving.
Mm.
How do you raise enough money to organize 10 competitions in Ghana,
okay,
where you have to ship all the athletes to the place, and so yeah, there are challenges.
What do we do?
We should make sure we plan well.
Mm-hmm. As for the planning, is we can't talk about planning well because how do you plan and the very basis for your plan, which is the facility you run on, are non-existent, and you say you have good plans. You can't have good plans if the facilities you run on are not there. So let's not talk about plan. It's not working.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Then we should just cross our hands and pray someone qualifies.
Mark,
as a nation, I think we really need to, like you said earlier on, we really need to decide if we really want sports to move forward or not.
I don't know whose decision that would be, whether it's President John Mahama or the sports minister. I'm not sure he even knows when he will be changed because we've changed 8 years.
You actually made a salient point that I think it is a good advice for
the sports minister.
No, the GA to consider.
You mean I made a point?
Yes.
Oh, okay, that's nice.
You see, I have been part of the team since 2002 to 2009.
Okay.
And what happened was that it got to a time our Tartan tracks were so bad. So we're all taken to Togo to camp for some weeks to make sure we qualify for African Championship relay and then Olympic Games.
So the plan was revised because you didn't have the facilities yet.
Yeah.
And that's the point I was making to you.
Yes.
We have a training camp scheduled when the students get out of school.
Okay.
Before the Olympics.
But ahead of the Olympics, locally, we don't have anything.
We do have local camping also planned.
But you run where? On these tracks, or where you're waiting
for people? Yes. Well, that's what we have. If we have to, and then there's also plans to send some athletes to Colombia, which the ministry is working on.
But you go all the way to Colombia where you can go to.
That is what the ministry has decided.
The ministry.
Yes, the sports ministry secured.
And how much do we need to go to Colombia, and that money cannot fix a tartan track for us?
How many athletes?
How many are we taking to Colombia? Two or three.
We need a high performance training center in Ghana if Ghana really needs to keep up with the world and, you know, get the rest.
Mark, you guys are struggling.
Oh, yeah.
I wonder how you are managing the sport.
We're doing our best.
Kweku, I understand there's an IAAF facility. Because what's his name? Lamine Diack was president for many years. There's a world-class facility there. Go to Senegal and train. What are you going to do in Colombia?
Yeah.
Colombia, they play
or even Mauritius. Mauritius, where Magasin was.
Yeah.
Okay,
Mauritius. Guys, thank you for your time. Kwekuni Mako and Magjadosi. We should do this again.
Yeah.
I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it.